All right, guys, it is Short Side Wristers. I'm No Sleeves 12. And on today's podcast, we're going to discuss the new content in Hut. The newest esports team is starting one of their events this weekend. And a little bit more news in regards to the new qualifiers and whatnot upcoming for this weekend in Versus. So let's jump into it. So let's start off with the newest tournament as far as esports goes, and that is the Detroit Red Wings. It is beginning this Friday the 25th on PlayStation and Xbox. Now, it's going to be run a little bit differently if you haven't seen the news about it. Basically, it's more of a regionalized event as opposed to the Washington Capitals and Lightning and Winnipeg offering travel, paid travel, as well as opening it up to Europe, North America for the Lightning and Capitals event. The Detroit event is more localized. Only Americans can play in it, and they aren't paying for travel. So if you are far away, obviously it's not going to be of value to go. I know a few pro players are going to be attempting to make the qualifier, but if you are local in Detroit area and you're pretty good at Hut or Chell, sorry, then this might be the competition for you. So there are 16. Now, I have to mention, it is run a little bit differently. So on every Friday, starting this Friday, the 25th at 7 p.m., and then Monday, Friday, for the next couple weeks, Xbox and PlayStation will run at the exact same time, starting at 7 p.m. Now, everyone's going to say, well, how are you starting a tournament at 7 p.m. and it's going to run all night? So what's happening is there's only a limited number of spots. First come, first serve. So when registration opens up, you need to be there right away to be able to register and actually play in the qualifier, because once it's filled up, you can't get in. So there's a set number of spots so that it doesn't take all night, which does make it a little more complicated, because if you're a pro player, you kind of got to sit there and just wait for it. Now, obviously, as it goes on, you might have an easier time just because of less people knowing about it, but and less hype as it goes on. But $5,000 is first prize, so that's nothing to, you know, nothing to overlook. Now, there also is two in-person qualifiers that at a location in Detroit. I believe it's a Hype Esports, or it's a bar of some kind, or you can go there to the live event and actually qualify there if you're in the area as well. I will be at this event, it seems, to help production and whatnot as far as with the event. So hopefully I get to see some of you guys. Now, for this one specifically, for the online qualifiers, you can use any team, which is crazy. All the other ones, you have to use the team that you're qualifying for, like Winnipeg, you have to be Winnipeg. In this, you can be any team. It's the LAN that you have to be Detroit. So for this one, on the online qualifier, you can be whatever you want, and that's obviously going to benefit a lot of players, because Detroit isn't really a team that you want to use in Versus. So again, there's 16 in total as far as qualifiers go, and if you are on PlayStation and Xbox, you could try alternating it, but they do start at the same time, so you can't really do both in one night. You could try, but you'll probably get forfeited. But there's a finite spot in each qualifier, each registration that you can qualify for. There's only about 32, I believe, that can actually get in. I don't know if it's more, but it's not going to run all night, so just something to watch out for. It's on Red Wings / Gaming NHL. Just Google Detroit Red Wings NHL 19 Faceoff, and you'll see it there. Registration for qualifier 3 and 4 is on the 25th. It opens on 1/25, so be ready for that if you want to qualify for the Detroit event. Let's get into the new Hut content that was released, because we're getting around that time when Prime Times and Milestone cards are actually going to replace Legends and be super valuable. So today was released at 94 Prime Time Alex Ovechkin with BU and FS, 96 speed across the board, but his shot, 95 shot power, slap shot power and accuracy, 94 wrist shot power and accuracy, and he's right-handed and big. This is going to be a card that everyone should want on their team. There isn't that many right-handed shots that are better than this card, and you could even put him on defense. I know a ton of people are super against that. I understand it. I'm big on putting forwards on defenses in this game, this season specifically, just because of how defensive players were nerfed as far as their shots go. But anyways, that's for a different podcast. But this Alex Ovechkin card is nuts. There's currently none on the market right now, so I can only imagine you're paying at least a mil, I would think, if you can find one for under that. The value of him is super high right now, but he is definitely a card that I would want to invest in if you had the coins. Now let's talk team of the week. This is hands down the worst team of the week so far, including like the first week of the season. So basically, our line one was an 83 Mika Zibanejad, an 83 Nolan Patrick, and an 84 Evander Kane. I love Mike Evander Kane, but at this stage of the game, these are cards that you're just not going to like be sought after. Even if you have a free-to-play team, I wouldn't recommend investing in any of these. Line two was an 86 Ryan O'Reilly with 90 speed and 82 shot, an 83 Matt Zuccarello, and an 88 Brad Marchand, 92, 86 shot. So it's like, whatever. And then on defense, an 85 Tyson Barrie, who has decent speed, so I guess if you're really dead set on putting defensemen on defense, he'd be an okay card, 94 speed. And then 89 Victor Hedman. Hedman has been the most disappointingly rated card the entire of all of NHL 19. He is the reason, like, Victor Hedman is the perfect example as to why I play forwards on defense this season, guys. He is, this card specifically, let's say, so the 89 Victor Hedman, 90 speed, super average at this point in the game. His slapshot accuracy is 77, and the slapshot power is 88. Like, every forward that's 85 and above is better than that. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's just no reason to have him on defense. Like, it's just disappointing because they did nerf, like, they're changing around how they lowered the overall ratings. And Victor and defense, they just nerf shot to a point where, like, there's just no reason to have many defensemen on defense where forwards are just better. The third line is an 86 Shea Weber. He's got 88 speed and his slapshot power is a 90, but the accuracy is a 75. So, like, and then an 88 Shane Goss to spare. This one, again, not terrible. 95 speed and 84 slapshot accuracy, 87 slapshot power. That's not terrible. But sell all of these if you pack any of them. Oh, my Lord. And then even the 90 Carey Price that you got. Carey Price, one of the better goalies in the game because he's very large and he's highly rated. But this one has FB and TB. The other one had BU. So it's like, it's just a big letdown all across the board here, guys. If you pack any Team of the Week players, get rid of them. Just sell them for the coins. I also want to bring this up here, something I'm going to start doing for Hutt. I get asked a ton of questions in regards to Hutt on stream and in my comments and on Twitter and whatnot about who to pick up. Like, say, if you guys haven't seen my Hutt team, it's ridiculous. And I've gotten in various ways, whether it be money, packs, all that kind of stuff, work in the market, all different ways. But I get a lot of people who are free to play, just started, and they're like, who do I go after? What's a good right wing for 80K? To be honest, I don't really know because I never really had to worry about it. I just have always had a really good team since the start, and I could just basically sell a player for like 400K, save up 400, and buy a new 800K player. Does that make sense? So I haven't really had to worry about the lower ones. But what I'm going to do is put in some research and whatnot, and starting with who you should start with, I'm going to give you guys a line to go buy. If you're a free-to-play player, you just open up your first pack, your starter team, and you're like, I don't know who to go after or what to do, I'm going to tell you guys. So I'm excited to do that because I just did my first one tonight, and I might release it, or sorry, last night, I guess, if by the time this comes out. So I want you guys to check that out. Yeah, I think it's going to be really beneficial. So basically, I go and I check the market for players that are under 10,000 each, and here's who you should go after when you're starting a brand new team, just to get a basis, and then you can start building out after that. And I'm going to do one for every section, whether it be 25 to 50K players, 50 to 100, and then so forth as we get up there. The ones that I would recommend using for Hutt this year, as Hutt gets more and more high end because of Team of the Year coming up and the overalls and players just kind of creeping up to that very, very high end state. So look forward to that, guys. Let me know again what you think and what you'd want to see in those kinds of videos in the comment section, or go check out the video and leave it there. I just wanted to mention that it is something new I'm starting. Lastly, guys, I just want to remind you again about the All-Star Game cards. I need you guys to pay attention. If you've watched me on stream, I've been trying to call my shot. I really want to do it, but I don't have the stones yet, but I think I'm going to tomorrow morning or this morning as you listen to this. If they play in the skills competition, happens on Friday night, okay, 9 p.m. Eastern time. They play in the skills competition. Be on the lookout for when the list comes out of who is playing in the skills competition, whether it be Friday morning, Friday afternoon, right before the event. The second that those cards are announced, or those players are announced for those events, specifically the hardest shot and accuracy challenge, you want to try and grab the guy you think will win those events, because they will get 3 stats boosted to 99 associated with that skills competition. So the two that most important are hardest shot, because their slap shot power and accuracy goes to 99, and then Accuracy Challenge, which will have the wrist shot and power and accuracy boosted to 99, which makes it just a fantastic buy because all these cards are going for around 400 or less, 400K and less. So my personal favorites, again, to be on the lookout for, if Seth Jones plays in the Hardest Shot competition, I've done the homework, I went and looked, there's no guy that in the competition that's in the All-Star game this year that has touched 100 in this event before. Laine's gone, Ovechkin's gone, Chara's not there, Weber's not there. The only guy that has done this competition before that's going, that has almost touched 100, is Seth Jones. Stamkos doesn't have a hard power shot. He's got a really accurate slap shot. Burns lives on his wrister. Do not invest in those guys because you think that they're going to win the Hardest Shot competition. It's probably going to be Weber or someone new. Is Seth Jones or someone new, because it's just, again, it's just a hunch of mine, but I think that you could cash in by getting 200K or 200 to 250K if you get the All-Star Seth Jones, and you'll get a 99 slap shot accuracy and power. The wrist shot one, if Crosby plays in it, he's dominated in the past. If he gets a 99 wrist shot power and accuracy, that All-Star card instantly becomes one of the best wingers in the game. He needs some speed, so hopefully he scores some goals in the actual All-Star game to boost all of his other stats by one. And then you've got, with BU, a fantastic card. And again, 400K and under, and you've turned him into an 800K worth. The speed ones I would kind of ignore just because there's already better versions of those cards that don't have to rely on luck. Goudreau, MacKinnon, and McDavid, they all already have 99 speed cards, so they'd have to win the event to get the All-Star card to 99 in speed, and then they would have to score goals to even boost up their other stats to come close. Like, McDavid would have to score like 7 goals to be worth more than the Christmas McDavid. If you really want McDavid, just go buy the Christmas McDavid. Same with Goudreau. His team of the week 92, already better than his All-Star one. So, and then in net, Rene at 300K, even the 89 Rene, say he doesn't get anything, is worth the investment. He's big, like one of the better goaltenders because he's large. But also, he might win the breakaway competition. He's done it in the past. Same with Fleury. They're both bigger goaltenders, and they both do well at the breakaway competition in years past. So they could get a couple stats boosted to 99. And then if they're on the winning team, they get plus 2. I think the Pacific probably has the best team. So, again, just something to watch for, guys. I have no, it's all guesswork. But Seth Jones and the Sharks as well, like Pavelski, I think will score a bunch of goals just because he's a hometown guy, and they're going to try and set him up. But it's just something to watch for. So, guys, that takes care of today's Short Side Wristers. Please leave a comment and a like on the video. Also, subscribe. It really helps me out. And let me know what you guys want me to talk about, or if you think I should grab another guest. Anything like that, let me know, and I will be sure to do that for you guys. Thank you for listening or watching. Have a great one.